Hello friends, welcome back. Previous video, we got to the point where we started working inside of our subscene, creating all the animation for the rest of our sequence here, and we paused because there's some issues that we're going to need to fix. So recapping really quickly, got to the point where we made our character walk forward, the bear will perform a melee attack, hit our character. However, there's going to be some issues with both of our characters, actually. This character here has built-in translation in the animation, so he gets shifted off so that when we try to play the next animation, he pops to that location. So we're going to fix that. We're also going to need to fix it for the bear here as well. So that's what we're going to do in this video. It should be a pretty short video, so we'll try to get through it as quickly as we can. So let's start with this guy here. Since we have him selected, it's going to be pretty quick and painless. One way we can fix this is to hide that with a camera cut. But that may not be always something that we want to do. So when he gets hit here, we could camera cut to this location, a different location, and just leave it as is, which would hide that pop, which you might see occur sometimes. Or we can try to fix it by moving the transform, which we'll do. So what we need to do is, as you can see, our character, we want him to fire from way back there, but in the next couple frames, he shifts forward. So I'm going to go to the track here. Make sure you're in the animation track of Shadow 4, which is inside the master. And what we'll do is we'll go to the end of this animation here. And we'll kind of try to make reference get an idea of where the character is at the end of this animation. So he's kind of like somewhere in here. So what we'll need to do is move this transform back in the next frame to somewhere back in there. So I don't know exactly where it is, and it may take some massaging to get it just right, but we'll give it a shot here. So we're at 683 is our frame that we're at. I'm gonna press S to start. This is the transform that we're gonna start at. I'm gonna go ahead of frame to 684. And if I pop back and forth between these two frames using the arrow keys, you can really see the problem here. So I'm gonna go ahead to 684 and then move this transform back to somewhere in there and then add a keyframe for that. So I'm gonna go ahead and let's move this back to somewhere in there. I'm gonna press S to add a keyframe. Let's see how close it is. It's pretty close, but still quite a bit of popping there. It looks like he's just a little bit too far back now when I go to that second frame there. So he needs to be in that position. But he's in that position. So it's very, very minor, but I'll try to slide him ahead just a little bit. Press S again. I think that's close enough. It's not bad. So if I zoom out, there might be one thing that happens with this as part of an artifact of this. If I play at full speed, you see that little pop there. So we're gonna have to fix that as well. It's the frames in between an actual frame. It's translating it. So what I'm gonna do is uncheck the grid snapping here for key snapping. Uncheck that. I'm gonna control mouse wheel in to zoom in. And now I should be able to slide this freely and don't have to snap it to an actual frame. So I'm gonna move this all the way over. Keep zooming in. Put it like right up next to it, so it's less than a 0.1 frames that this will happen. So it should minimize it. Is that all the way in? I think that's all the way in. Oops. Yeah, that was all the way in. I think that's good. Let's try this. Zoom all the way out. So now if I play, yeah, much better. Hopefully down the road we'll have some measures to account for things like this, but this is kind of a workaround that you can take. I know some of the guys on our team had mentioned in previous Twitch streams that you can hide this type of thing with camera cuts, but this is a way that I found to get around this as well. So that looks good. He's going to fire his cannon from about that range. It's pretty close, so our bear is going to get really blasted right here. So it's only going to be like couple frames. I'm actually going to turn back on the snapping here so that we go on individual frames now instead of less than a frame. So somewhere about there's the fire. So somewhere about 7:30, I guess, is where we're going to want to play a hit react for our bear here. So let's take our bear's idle. I'm going to pull this back to 7:30. Gonna add an animation. He has a, it's gonna be a death actually, because he's gonna be dead at this point, so we'll say death. Let's try death 2. Let's see what that one is. I think that's the one where he goes flying back. Yeah, that looks good. So he's gonna fire because he's so close. He gets really blasted back. And we'll add a particle effect to kind of make it look like he's actually firing the cannon. Kind of tumbles over. That looks good. Now our character here, he's gonna need to go back into an idle at this point, so he's not just standing there stiff. So let's add an idle for him. So just idle. Or the summons again if you want, or a different animation. But that looks good. And that's really going to be the end of our scene. We may need to do a couple adjustments on the bear. Let me select the bear real quick. Yeah, there it is. I knew there was another one we needed to touch. So the same thing with our bear here. The end of his animation, this is the swipe, I believe. Yeah. So when he swipes, translates all the way forward. He starts, his transform starts in the middle, but when he finishes his animation, he ends with it at the back. So when we play our next animation, he pops back to that location. So we gotta fix that. So it's similar to what we just did. We're just gonna add a keyframe for this position. So at 662, press S, add a keyframe. Let's zoom out just a little bit. Go to the next frame. And then we're gonna need to push the bear forward a little bit. So something like that, press S. A little bit further forward. That's pretty close. And the same thing's gonna happen here if we zoom all the way out and we play this. You're gonna see that pop. We can fix that again. If we zoom in, take off grid snapping, drag this over, get it really close so that the amount of frames that pass between this transform is very, very small. I'm just control mouseing up. I think that's good. Something like that. So now if we pull all the way out, play. Yeah, we don't see anything now. Looks good. And let's see, if we play all the way out, I think that's really gonna be the end of our sequence. So it plays all the way through. In fact, it plays all the way from the beginning because we duplicated that shot. Shadow 3, which had the other animation in it. So theoretically, we could reshoot this whole thing with this subscene with different camera angles using just this for all the animation for shot 1, 2, and 3. So that is really going to be it for this video. We just did some animation, so our work as the animator is done. Now it's up to the cinematic folks to create the the cameras for our scene. So we're gonna need to add the cameras. We'll do that in the next video, as well as a little bit of polish, because I'm seeing some sliding around here now that we've added some keyframes. We'll make sure that everything's nice and neat before we finish out the series here. Got a couple more videos to go and we'll be done. Thank you guys for watching. We'll see you in the next video.